Good morning to all. In our COVID-19 patient care area, we have to wear the personal protective equipment and we have to remove it. It is very important how we are wearing it and removing it. Donning and doffing of PPE is very, very important, especially while donning, we have to do without touching any area of the body or without contaminating the surface, we have to remove the PPE. So for this reason, I am demonstrating how we have to put the PPE and how we have to remove the PPE. I am going to show you. When we come from home, we have to wash our hand first. Okay, washing is very, very important. Say, because we came from the home, we are touching our vehicle, touching the door knob and the railing. Wherever we touch, we don't know what are all organisms there. Like COVID-19 organism will be there, MRSA will be there, VREA will be there, MSSA will be there. So we have to wash our hand thoroughly first, then we have to remove our personal belongings and we have to remove our own dress, then we have to put the pajama in the COVID area. After washing our hand, we have to put the surgical cap first. When you put the surgical cap, it has to completely cover your forehead. Then you have to wear the shoe cover. When you wear the shoe cover, you can sit comfortably. It has to come till the knee. The same way the other shoe cover, you can pull it till the knee. After wearing the shoe cover, we may touch our shoe, so you have to do the hand hygiene. I am taking 2 push-up hand-up solution, that is 3 ml. You have to do palm to palm with interlace 5 times, back to palm with interlace 5 times, then the other hand back to palm with interlace 5 times, then interlace fingers for the web spaces 5 times, then interlock and over the hand you have to do for the knuckles 5 times, the same way the other hand you have to do it for 5 times, then for the thumb finger in the rotational rubbing you have to do 5 times, both thumb finger you have to do it 5 times, then you have to clasp fingers, keep the finger in the inner aspect of the palm for the nail bud as well as the fingertip and the inner aspect of the palm. When you do 6 steps completely, the hand become dry off. After drying the hand, you have to wear the inner glove. You pull it over the hand. Then you have to take the coverall. In the coverall, it has the hood, then the zip, at the back there is a ties. Okay, you just gently avoid this hood, then pull the zipper down completely, then you stand over the Macintosh or a clean sheet, then it won't touch the coverall won't touch the floor. After putting the leg, you identify the hand sleeve, you just put it, then come forward, lean forward and it will then pull the gown. Okay, after that put the zip up little bit, then you tie the knot. The knot should be in a removable way you have to put. Then after putting the thing, you have to wear the N95 mask. When you wear the N95 mask, you have to be very careful. You have to keep the mask, keep the N95 respirator just like a cup. It has the 2 strings, it has to be dangled down, okay, over the hand. Then in the nose piece, gently you press it, keep it in your nose and mouth. Then you just fit it properly. After fitting it, you just check the fit check. When you do the fit check, when we exhale, that is the positive pressure check, the mask should bulge outward, okay? When you inhale, the mask should drawn inward, that is the negative pressure check. Then only the mask is working properly. So you have to keep the nose piece and the mouth over the nose and the mouth. Then keep the nose strap over the occipital region. Then you pull the chin strap, bring it back behind the ear and put it on the top of the head, okay? Then take two fingers, you just press it slowly, then you do the fit check. When you do the fit check, keep your hand like this. Inhale, mask should draw inward. When exhale, the mask should bulge outside. Then only it is functioning. Then after putting the mask, you have to wear the goggles. When you take the goggle, don't touch the front of the goggle. You have to pull the strap, okay? Put it over the eyes and the nose bridge. If it is fitting properly, you can leave it. Otherwise, with the two straps, you just pull it, keep it snugly. Then you try whether it is moving or not. If it is fixing properly, you can continue the other step, okay? Now we can cover the hood. You have to pull it completely. It has to cover the face. Pull the gown little bit down. Put the zipper up. Then the zipper should be downward. Okay? You check whether any empty space is there. So you have to cover completely. After that, you have to put the outer glove. The outer glove completely cover over the cuff of the coverall. Okay, you have to select according to your hand size. If it is too loose, means we have to adjust each time. If it is too tight also, difficult to do the task, okay? This is the donning procedure. Thank you. After doing the procedure or doing the task for the patient, we have to doff the PPE. When we doff the PPE, this is a designated area. That area only we have to doff the PPE. When we doff the PPE, if the hand is like dirt is there, you can put the hand rub over that. Otherwise, straight away you can remove the tie. Then after that, you have to pull it down the zipper little completely down. Okay, don't touch the mask or the outer surface of the gown. Then you have to remove the outer glove. While removing the outer glove, you have to pinch it outside. Then slowly you peel it off. Keep it in the other hand. Then put two fingers inside. Slowly remove it without touching outer surface of the glove. Because the inner glove is clean right now. You have to put it in the red bag. Now the inner glove is clean. If you feel, if you want to put the hand rub, you can put it. Otherwise, I can remove the hood first. Okay? Take two fingers without touching outer side of the body or without touching the mask or goggles. I have to go in. Okay? Gently avert this hood. Then keep it in the shoulder. Now you can put two fingers inside the sleeve of the coverall, pull it down. The same way, the other hand, you put two fingers, pull it down, catch inner side of the gown. You catch the inner sleeve, slowly you remove it. When it
found out of the shoulder, near the waist, you bend forward, pull it out the sleeve. Okay, the inner side has to come out and the outer side will go in. With this, slowly you roll it. When you roll it, you catch these two ties with you without hanging. Okay, slowly pull it down. You can sit comfortably and you can remove. Pull the left side first. While removing, all the inner surface has to come out. You have to discard it in the yellow bag. People who are not able to do with this method, you can follow one sleeve method also. You can pull it out, catch the inner side of the sleeve, then you push it, push your hand and bring your hand out. You gently touch here, without touching your body, you remove it. Then this hand is clean only, go inside and remove this sleeve. Inside has to come out. Then you have to roll it the same way. After removing the coverall, we have to remove the shoe cover. Pinch outside of the shoe cover and pull it down. When it comes down, you invert this one and put it in the yellow bag. The same way, the other shoe cover, the same way you pull it out and put it in the yellow bag. Now my hand is contaminated with the shoe. I can put the hand wrap. I have to do the all six steps, palm to palm, back to palm, interlace, interlock, both hands, then thumb finger, both hands. Then in the respect of the palm, by the time the hand become dry off, the glove become dry off. Now I have to remove the goggles. When you remove the goggle, you pull this strap, okay? Then lean forward, remove it slowly. Otherwise it will sweep your eyes. Put it in the red bag. Now the mask is there, N95 respirator. If you want, you can put the hand wrap. Otherwise, straight away you can remove the N95 mask. While removing the N95 mask, you have to remove the lower tie first. That is the chin strap first. For that, it is in the over our head. Pull it down. Okay. Keep it like this. Then the nose strap, you identify. Pull it. Lean forward, remove it, discard it in the yellow bag. Now the hair cap is there, this is clean only, you can just remove it. Now I have the inner glove, you have to remove the inner glove, pinching the outside of the glove near the wrist, remove it slowly, keep it in the other gloved hand. Put two fingers inside, slowly peel it off and remove it. Make it as a pouch, discard it in the red bag. After putting the glove, you have to wash your hand, not the hand rub, you have to wash your hand. Open the tap, wet your hand, take adequate amount of hand wash solution, then rub it palm to palm with interlace 5 times. Back to palm with interlace 5 times. Then the other hand back to palm with interlace 5 times. Then interlace fingers for the web spaces 5 times. Then interlock fingers for the knuckles over the
palm of the hand you have to rub. The same way the other hand over the palm of the hand you have to rub for 5 times. Then you have to hold the thumb finger. That is a rotational movement you have to do 5 times. The same way the other thumb. Then clasp fingers in the respect of the palm, clockwise and anti-clockwise. The same way the other hand clockwise and anti-clockwise you have to do. Then you have to wash your hand the same way. You wash your hand. Use the paper towel. You pat the hand, don't rub the hand. With the same towel, paper towel, you can close the tap.